Boop beep.
Hello, this is Ernest from Star Trek Is Life. Well, if you're a true Star Trek fan, then you might want to get the Blu-ray set. It just came out, just got released. So here we go. Why should you want to get the Blu-ray set? I mean, we just watched it on CBS All Access, right? We watched every single episode. So why do we want a hard copy? And the reasons are... Drumroll, please. Never mind. Okay, so if you're an audiophile, then you might want to consider getting the Blu-ray. It's got lossless compressed DTS-HD 5.1 channel surround sound. So if you want to hear everything the way that they meant it to be before CBS All Access compressed the heck out of it and squeezed it down to your system, then this is the way to go. The other reason is video quality. Like we were saying before, CBS All Access compressed the heck out of it and squeezed it down to our systems in 720p. So if you want to see true HD, then the only way to do that is to buy the Blu-ray disc. You'll be happy you did, because you don't only get superior audio quality and video quality, you also get special features. And each special feature is 10 to 20 minutes apiece. All right, starting with the special features, we have Discovery, the concepts and the cast of Star Trek Discovery, executive producers Alex Kurtzman, Aaron Harberts, and Gretchen Berg discuss casting Screen 1. Another special feature, Standing in the Shadow of Giants, creating the sound of Discovery. Alex Kurtzman and composer Jeff Russo talk about creating the Discovery theme. What's next? Creature Comforts. Glenn Ketrich, Neville Page, members of the makeup crew discuss their designs for the aliens. We get to see Doug Jones made up by James McKinnon, and Mary Chifo talks about being Lirel. And it doesn't end there. It goes on and on, designing Discovery. Todd Chernyowski discusses designing the USS Shenzo, the USS Discovery, and the Klingon sarcophagus ship. Creating Space, Alex Kurtzman discusses using feature film quality visual effects and the blend between practical and computer graphics. Jason Zimmerman, Star Trek Discovery's VFX supervisor, discusses the process of bringing Burnham's space flight from the pilot to life. Prop Me Up, a look at one of the more successful aspects of the Discovery production, the props. A Woman's Journey, a feature discussing Burnham's journey and the larger representation of women in the front and behind of the camera. We hear the executive producers, Heather Cotten and Alex Kurtzman, actors Sonequa Martin-Green, Michelle Yao, and Mary Chifo, and writers Bo Yun Kim, Erica LePolt, and Kirsten Beyer. Yes, but are we done? No, there's more special features. Dress for Success, a look at costume designer Gersher Phillips and her team. They discuss designing the Discovery uniforms, all the layers of detail that go into the Klingon uniforms and costumes, and the design of the Mirror Universe. Jason Isaacs talks about squeezing into the disco uniform, and Mary Wiseman, Michelle Yao, and Sonequa Martin-Green discuss the mirror costumes. Feeding Frenzy, a look at how the Discovery food stylists made the banquet of food Burnham and Emperor Giorgio eat in Vaulting Ambition. A particular challenge was making edible prop versions of Kelpian ganglia that were vegan-friendly for the ganglia soup. And to top it all off, the Discovery features end in the voyage of Season 1. It's a 40-minute look at the entire season, and it's probably the most interesting and comprehensive of all of the features. But is that it? No! In addition to superior audio, superior video, and awesome special features, you also get deleted scenes. Deleted scene number 1, Battle at the Binary Stars. This is an extended scene of young Takuma dusting himself off after being beaten and swearing to unite the great houses in Kallus' name. Deleted scene number 2, The Butcher's Knife Cares Not for the Lamb's Cry. In this deleted scene, Lirel and Vok, plus a few other followers of Takuma's, gathered around a dying Klingon. Lirel kills the dying Klingon to stretch their resources. They discuss how everyone on board is starving and losing faith. Lirel says they need to take more drastic measures, but Vok pushes back, telling Lirel she may not kill anyone else. Deleted scene number 3, Choose Your Pain. In this deleted scene, or scenes we should say, there's a number of trims of Saru as acting captain. Number 1, Saru records an acting captain's log about being uneasy, calling the barren planet they're currently orbiting the Orb of Our Undoing. Clip 2, Saru finds Tilly and others locked out of the engineering bay by Stamets, who has passed out in the reaction chamber from injecting himself with tardigrade DNA. Clip number 3, Saru congratulates the crew for a job well done. Then, as seen in the final version, he goes to the ready room to hear his analysis as acting captain, which he cancels. Deleted scene number 4, magic to make the sanest man go mad. This is a deleted scene that followed Burnham swallowing a weaponized dark matter orb in the ready room. Cut to Stamets and Tilly discussing Burnham's risky plan with Lorca, who was locked in the brig by Mud, and wondering if Mud will take the bait of being able to turn Burnham over to the Klingons if he resets the time loop one last time. Deleted scene number 5. What's past is prologue. Lorca gives a speech to his compatriots in the agonizer boots before setting them free. Deleted scene number 6. Will you take my hand? This is a bonus scene of Leland recruiting Emperor Giorgio into Section 31 as first shown at WonderCon. So as you can see, there are many, many reasons to run out and get the DVD or Blu-ray version of Star Trek Discovery Season 1. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing. As always, thank you for watching Star Trek is Life. I'll see you next time. Beep boop.